Come on, you can do better than that. Make some noise. And now, please welcome to the stage your host, Stacy Hello.
A round of applause for being in the best possible place to be tonight. I am Stacy. I will be your host. By round of applause, who has been to Curious Comedy Theater before? Awesome. Welcome back. Hi. I haven't seen you in a while. Welcome back. Welcome back. Great. By round of applause, who is here for the very first time? Awesome. Great. Welcome. And let me just say, this is our 16th year, so where the fuck have you been? No, it's okay. It's okay. I'm glad you're here now. We grew real slow, real grassroots organization. Fantastic. Well, what you're going to see tonight is an entirely improvised show. Everything that happens up here is going to be made up on the spot, just for you, inspired by you, and for us to share in this moment with each other, and also on the internet, where we will be live streaming the show. So everybody say, hi, internet!
Hi, internet!
Fantastic. I'm gonna warm you up, because we will come to you for suggestions and ideas and thoughts. Please share when we come to you for those things. Please do not share when we don't come to you for those things, because everybody paid to see what's mostly happening up here. So just to get you a little bit warmed up, I mentioned my name is Stacy. What's yours? One, two, three. Very nice. And I just have my birthday because I'm an Aries. What are you? One, two, three. A lot of Tauruses, a lot of Tauruses. Aries and Tauruses get along really well. Excellent. And what I'm looking forward to is taking some trips this summertime, springtime, summertime. What's something you're looking forward to as the days and the lights come back? One, two, three.
Tennis.
That's right. Tennis? Somebody say tennis? Awesome. Excellent. Great. Well, I'm going to bring out our players in a moment, but first we have a couple of little things we need to take care of. First of all, please give it up to the person who will be improvising on the keys throughout the night, Mr. Knut Snordum. Also, round of applause for Philip, who's on lights and sound. And you can't see them because they're in a video booth, but operating the cameras are Mila and John. And one more point of business before I bring the players out, which is, I don't know, has anybody heard of like a tenet of improv before? What's like the main tenet of improv?
Yes, and.
Yes, and. That's right. And you're supposed to, like, cooperate and play together. But here, improv is about fucking winning. So this is a competitive night of improv, and you are the judge and jury. These players will be competing for your love, your laughs, and your votes. And the way that works is that I will, after they do a game or scene, I will come to you, I will say, is it a one, two, three, four, or five? One is, I saw a thing on stage. Three is, oh, that was pretty funny. And five is, that was so funny, I'm gonna be thinking about it on the car ride home and talking about it tomorrow at breakfast. Or brunch if you don't wake up too early. All right, so to start, let's practice that. Let's score how ready you are to have a good time tonight. Okay, are you at a one, a two, a three, a four, a five? Nice. What can I get you? Do you need like coffee or? All right, without further ado, please give it up for the Curious Comedy Players. Yeah. All right, all right. We're gonna give our players a chance, and I actually am gonna change my question.
No!
I want to ask you, because I thought of it while I was talking about my birthday, what is one of your best or worst birthday presents that you have ever received. And if you don't want to go in order, you can go in whatever order you want. Alex, do you have one?
Yeah. Hi, I'm Alex. This year, my boyfriend got me tickets to Annie, but I haven't seen it yet. So it could be the best, but it could be the worst.
The Annie, the like old
tomorrow.
Wow. That one. Minus 2 points. We're not going to see Annie about 40 years too late. All right, Kyle.
My name is Kyle, he, him, and my birthday was just like 6 days ago or so, I'm not counting. And we celebrated my birthday at a dive bar with some friends, but I had one friend that wasn't in town, and he called my other friend and had him order a drink for me, and it was a Red Bull vodka. And so I dumped it out and took a photo of the empty glass and sent a photo that I drank it, and I said, yum, yum.
1 point for Kyle for self-care. Birthday really close to mine.
Fair enough, yeah.
All right, Roz.
My name is Roz, she, her pronouns, and the best gift I've gotten is like a paper. Okay, so you know those boxes of strawberries? Yeah. It's that, but instead of real strawberries, it was needle felted strawberries.
Wow.
Yeah, thank you for hearing me out.
Minus one for Roz taking way too long. No, it wasn't that bad.
I'll take it.
Janelle, she, her. I come from a family of lots of kids. We didn't get birthday parties, but we got one when we were five. So my favorite birthday gift was my five-year-old birthday party where I got to go to a bouncy house. It's like Chuck E. Cheese, but it was not that cool.
Wow.
That was the best.
For Janelle, for all the birthdays, she got nothing. I hope that makes up for it a little bit. I'm sure it does.
Sure does.
That's a hard one to follow. My name is Heather. I use she, her pronouns, and the best birthday gift I ever got was the staff and cast members here at Curious threw me a surprise birthday party 2 weeks ago.
Yes! 5 points for Heather, because I helped with that party.
Hi. I'm Jack. I got a gift once. A girlfriend gave me like this, and I open it up, and it's this big red dictionary. And I'm like, what the what? But she had taken an X-Acto knife and cut out the middle so I could hide shit in it. Mm-hmm. So cool.
Yes. Yeah.
Do you still have it?
I don't know where it is.
Given you positive.
I would never lie. Everything tonight is true.
Aww. All right, and as you can see, I also have the power to give or take points away as I see fit throughout the night. All right, to get the players warmed up, our first game will be an all play, and it is called Tag Team Song. Can I get a suggestion of a profession?
Marketing.
Marketing. Sorry, Alex, you're at work now. a marketing manager. So anything to do with marketing, right? We're gonna do a love song about marketing. We're inspired by that suggestion. And the way this works is one person's gonna step up. They're gonna start singing this song. And then at some point, someone else can come up, tag them, and that person will have to continue the song seamlessly, whether it was in the middle of a word, in the middle of a breath, in the middle of a sweet run, and then someone else will come on, and they'll just can keep rotating through it, as if it's one person singing it. You get one voice, but they're all doing it. Okay, great. All right, we're gonna see this tag team song, inspired by marketing managers, in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I get a feeling deep down.
trust that you know who I am. You know how I know it is because all of your sensual posts on Insta.
Graham. Oh, and you know every day I log on to Wikipedia because then I log on to Facebook, aka social media. Love I had, and this is not an ad. Yeah, you are the best love I had. This is not an ad.
Yeah, that's right. You're the best love that I had. It's not a motherfucking
ad. Not a motherfucking ad.
Problems we don't have enough reach.
Reach. Yeah, I got the end of that rhyme.
Let's try it again. You were the best love that I had, and baby, this isn't a night.
Heather out here. Everybody else can have a seat. We're gonna need two chairs, my friends. And we're gonna play a game here. I'm gonna need some suggestions from you to help us. And I need, what are emotions that people feel? Name some emotions. Okay. All right, hold on. I heard sadness, panic, and resentment. The sun is coming back, I promise you.
Disgust.
What was this?
Amorous.
Euphoria. Amorous. Euphoria. We got some.
Someone said horny. I just want to make sure
horny.
That's right.
Horny. Oh, okay. Somebody always says horny. Let me hear from the balcony.
Yeah.
Gratitude. That's the opposite of entitlement is gratitude. My boyfriend tells me that all the time. It's not a lie. How about from over here?
Discombobulation.
Discombobulation. Great. Two more.
Angsty.
What was that?
Existential dread.
Ooh, dread. Oh, existential dread.
Are you guys okay?
The opposite of horny.
And scared. Okay, I think we have enough.
Great.
Great. So Jack and Heather are going to be on probably a first date, I'm going to say. This will be their first date. And Jack is an emo kind of guy. So in the course of their date, I'm gonna ring the bell and I'm gonna say some of these emotions. And his character is going to have to cycle through the emotions that you all just gave me. And Heather's going to just have to have a date with this emotional person. So one more question. Where are they on their date?
Wendy's.
I can't tell you how often it's a fast food place, so I hope you're not all going to fast food places on your date. All right, you're on Wendy's on your first date.
Perfect.
And we're gonna see this countdown with me in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I'm gonna insist on paying. I like to treat, you know, just as a gesture of I'm so excited to be here.
That's great, because you know? I'm gonna order a lot. And I'm not going to pay for it, if that's your job.
Yeah.
Panic!
Yeah, that's absolutely fine. I checked my bank account earlier and I'm covered for this.
Dave, are you okay?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I think I'll just, can I send back this soft drink?
I don't think you can do that at Wendy's.
Sadness.
It's fine. It's just I wanted everything to go perfect.
Okay. Hey, I'm having a great time.
Oh, yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Really?
I'm having a really good time.
Thanks so much for reassuring me. I promise you won't have to do that the whole time.
Okay.
It's awesome that you're a painter. I just think that's so.
Yeah. I've always been like super creative since I was like a kid.
Scared.
Yeah. Though some of your work is a little too avant-garde. You know, I saw some of the stuff you posted. I'm like, this is cool, but what does that one mean where it's the canvas and then it's just gray? What does it mean?
That means my childhood was very gray. I grew up in Seattle. Well,
existential dread.
That's amazing that you can put that in there. I guess I never thought about how my childhood was rough too. Yeah, I guess it was. You know, it's just like, am I ever gonna get over it, or is it gonna hold on to me forever?
Maybe you should take up painting. Get a lot of feelings out.
Maybe so. I mean, when I walked
in here,
I was like, this is disgusting. Why did I? But this is what I can afford. And then I saw you in I brightened up. I brightened up. I was so excited.
That's really sweet. And yeah. A little confusing, but
Everything's always confusing right when you start out. Like, I feel like we're gonna get to know each other.
It's true. Okay, you know what? I've been talking a lot about myself. Sure. Where did you grow up?
Oh my gosh.
Joy.
Disneyland. That's when I really feel like I came into my own. I just remember being 8 years old and getting up on the, now I'm going through the space roller coaster.
Yeah, Space Mountain.
I just felt like I really grew up at Disneyland.
Yeah, well, that's amazing. What's your favorite character? Mine is, I really love Goofy.
Goofy.
Yeah.
Amorous.
Goofy. Goofy.
Yeah. Amorous.
Amorous.
Yeah, what's it mean?
It's like, loving.
Yeah. I love Goofy. I absolutely, when we both said that, it was almost like there was like a spark.
We have so much in common.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I love Vanilla Frosties and you love Vanilla Frosties and we both love Goofy. And
resentment. Huh? Resentment.
Yeah, we both love Goofy. My favorite childhood character, and now we both love Goofy. Okay. It was almost like right when I said Goofy, you just said it right after, like you pretend that we said it at the same time.
I'm pretty sure I said it first.
Well, I remember, if anything, I said it almost at the same time.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Euphoria.
I'm so sorry. It feels so good to apologize. Like, God, I have so many dates where I just resented the person the whole time and I didn't say anything. I'm immediately sorry for everything I've done so far. And everything I'm going to do. I want to apologize in advance.
Wait a second.
Yeah.
You you're going to do. So are you asking me on a second date?
Well,
horny.
I was thinking the second date could start right now.
Get to vote, and here it is. Was that emo date, was it a one, a two, a three, four, five? Wow. Great job. Have a seat. Let's bring up everybody else. Kyle, Rob, Janelle, and Alex. All right, friends. By round of applause, how many of you are chronically late? Again, there are a few people reluctant to admit it. By round of applause, who's always furious at people who are late? Because really, you're only one of those two things. Roz, you're going to be late, so we need to see you leave the room now. We're going to say bye, Roz. I am going to get some suggestions. She's going to our soundproof outside. That's right, that's all we can afford. We are a nonprofit, and if you see right here, you can donate using this QR code, and we might be able to buy an actual soundproof booth or pay our bills. Okay.
Which of the four QR codes?
Yes. Yeah. No, we could make a link tree, but no. We put all the QR codes out at once. Okay. All right, so we're going to play a game. It's called Late for Work. Roz is going to be late for work, but her boss has discovered that she's late, and her coworkers, who are kind and loyal to her, have given an excuse of why she's late. But when Roz gets here, they're not gonna have an opportunity to tell her what that excuse is, so Roz is gonna have to figure it out. I need from you, what's a rather standard reason somebody might be late? What was that back here?
I said she's done the plate.
She got the plague.
That's not very standard.
Super standard.
Yeah. I'm gonna save the plague. And somebody said, somebody had one over here.
I ran over a dog.
Oh, not no. Today.
Traffic.
I had a rough week, y'all. How about over here?
Got lost.
A migraine. She had a migraine. Okay, great. So she had a migraine. Yep. And then the second reason is she contracted the plague.
Great. Great.
And who did she get the plague from? Snoopy.
Snoopy.
She got the plague from Snoopy.
So that's all the second one?
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Uh-huh. I'm going to write these down.
Yeah, the plague was easy.
Plague from Snoopy. The first one was a migraine. Thank you. I should know that as somebody who gets them. Okay. And then lastly, they're going to have to explain how she eventually does get to work. So what's like a fantastic, unbelievable, whimsical way that somebody might...
Hot air balloon.
What was that?
Hot air balloon.
Hot air balloon. Great. And let's put someone in the hot air. What like a public figure is in the hot air balloon?
Jules Verne.
She might get that. What's that? Nick Cage?
Yeah, that's good.
Nick Cage. She's probably more likely to get Jules Verne. But we're going to say Nick Cage. Okay. So she is in a hot air balloon with Nick Cage, is how she actually gets her. Nicolas Cage, yes. Great. So first excuse, migraine. Second excuse, plague from Snoopy. And third answer of how she actually eventually got there is in a hot air balloon with Nicolas Cage.
Perfect.
Great, so when she comes in, they're gonna start trying to show her from behind their boss's back, and she's gonna have to guess from the physical clues she gets from these players. All right, you gave her a tough job.
Yeah.
So let's see if she can do it. Everybody on the count of three say, get back here, Roz. One, two, three.
Get back here, Roz.
Great, and we're gonna see this late to work in five, four, three, two, one.
Hey,
before you enter this Blockbuster, you're late for the third time this week, okay?
I know, I'm so sorry, Alex. I can explain.
Yeah, sure, your coworkers are hard at work. Look at them. Emotional. Studious.
Guys, I'm so sorry.
Why were you late?
So I had this pounding headache the moment that I woke up. Oh. And it was so bad. It was a migraine.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I'm not gonna lie to you, that takes like 15 minutes and you're a full hour late.
True, I've talked many times about my advanced leave.
It's gotta be more than that.
Well, it's not just the migraine.
Sure.
I was, there were just so many termites that just crawled into the room and started, and they made me faint, and I was nauseous, and I mean, I passed out. I straight up passed out on the floor. Someone carved the letter X onto me. And it was really intense. Oh no, it wasn't a person though. It was a creature.
I don't believe any of that. Your coworkers are hard at work. Look at this form of replacing DVDs. I don't think any of that was true. Of anything you just said. Why were you really late?
It's just, I'm sorry, I was embarrassed to tell you what really happened. I was... I was mowing the lawn. No, I was selling hot dogs. I was selling hot dogs.
Honestly, I'm not gonna lie, your laughter is infectious. I wanna laugh too, you know? It's infectious.
And so, listen, I really can explain it to you. It's just...
Please.
I mean... It's allergy season.
Sure.
And I had such a bad allergic reaction that it was, I simply dropped dead. I dropped dead from allergies. I passed out from my allergy to chipmunks, mosquitoes.
You are
squirrels.
You are
squirrels. Baby there.
I don't need all this medieval drivel. Look at these incredible workers hard at work. I feel like you're putting me in the dark ages with all these excuses.
And it's really funny you mentioned that, Alex,
sure.
Because it wasn't allergies, it was the bubonic plague.
It's
the little rats, they were just crawling everywhere, but it's not actually the rats, it's the germs on the rats, it's the fleas on the rats.
You know, and fleas do live on specific animals, as they say.
That's right.
Maybe famous ones?
Yeah, but they're not rats, they're...
Contract this from someone specific and famous.
Oh, you mean Remy the Rat, huh?
I how dare you? Remy's plague free.
No, not Remy, but he definitely was a rat though, right? No, he wasn't.
That can't be true. That's too obvious.
About this often, but beagles like Snoopy. So it's been a very illness-fueled day
for
me.
Harrowing, but how did you eventually get to work?
No, I think that's a very fair question. I took my magic umbrella, I unfurled it, and I tossed it aside for...
Listen, these people are working! Patricia would never be late.
Hey, Patricia.
So how did you get here?
Hot air balloon.
And were you alone?
I was with someone else. I... better.
Okay. It's more specific.
And as we were looking up, floating through the skies, I said, what's it like being the Joker? What's it like being Two-Face? What's it like being the Riddler? And they didn't answer any of those questions. Like, I'm none of those people.
Jesus, are you all getting these? Oh my God, wow. I didn't realize you were so passionate about movies.
Oh yeah, I love the Royal Tenenbaums.
So. Oh yeah, oh God, are you, these bees in here, not the bees. Oh God. So you were in a hot air balloon, but
yes,
you had an accomplice, of course.
And it was Nicolas Cage.
Yes! Yes!
Let's score that game. Was it a one, a two, a three, a four, a five? Was it a six? I'm gonna give you each a five and Roz six.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you, thank you.
All right, let's get everybody up here. Let's get everybody. We're gonna have a little palate cleanser. All right, you've seen them act. You've seen them mime, you've seen them sing, but now these performers are gonna tell some jokes. And this game is called Sex With Me. But it's not about sex with me, it's about sex with them. And this, I'm gonna get some suggestions from you. And the way it works is I'll get a suggestion, they'll step forward, and they will have to use that suggestion in a joke in the form of sex with me is like blank. And then they'll have to come up with a pun or punchline. For example, if you gave the suggestion cow, like sex with me is like a cow. Utterly fantastic. Yes. Thank you for cheering and also for groaning, because this is a pun-friendly game. So if you groan, moan, laugh, cheer, make any sound out your face, I will ring my bell and that player will get a point. If I really like it or you really like it, I may ring it twice. They'll get 2 points. If you are crickets on their joke, I will honk the horn. They will get no points. If their joke is super bad to the point where I'm like a little uncomfortable, I'll honk the horn twice and they will lose a point. Yikes. All right, so to get started, can I have a suggestion?
We talked.
Whoa, wow. Dentistry. I didn't even ask. Okay, dentistry.
Oh, did you want to do 5, 4, 3, 2, 1?
Yeah, no, you can go.
Okay,
no.
Sex with me is like dentistry. I'm gonna bite. Sex with me is like dentistry. You better believe I'm gonna get that cavity filled.
Sex with me is like dentistry. My assistant's gonna do most of the work.
Sex with me is like dentistry, better with laughing gas.
Sex with me is like dentistry. I really need to spit.
Sex with me is like dentistry. We're gonna schedule the next one about 6 months from now.
All right. Sounds about right. Okay. Can I have a suggestion? Talked a lot about birthday gifts. What's a birthday gift you have given or received?
Lego.
I heard Legos. Legos.
Sex with me is like Legos. Sometimes it's hard to put me together, but once you do, it's worth it. Sex with me is like Legos. I want you to step on me.
Sex with me is like Legos. Sometimes it's Star Wars themed. Sometimes it's like just like people in the town.
Sex with me is like Legos. Gets more expensive every year.
Sex with me is like Legos. You know you want this brick house.
Sex with me is like Legos. I actually have a set of instructions here, if you don't mind.
Sex with me is like Legos, lots of edging.
Two for going over some of the audience's heads. So. all right, oh, last suggestion. What is something you keep in a shed or a garage? What was that? A hoe.
Wow.
A hoe. It's a little on the nose, yeah, so I'm going to challenge you to work around it. Hoe is your last suggestion.
Sex with me is like a hoe. You dig deep enough, it's gonna get real dirty.
Sex with me is like a hoe. Ideally, I'd like you to plant your seed.
Sex with me is like a hoe. You're gonna wanna make fun of it, but remember that I'm a person too.
All right, I'll get another suggestion. One more. See first. I heard platypus. Platypus is your suggestion.
Sex with me is like a platypus. I couldn't quite describe it or draw it, but I know it when I see it.
Sex with me is like a platypus. There's a big bill.
I'm really sorry about this. Sex with me is like a platypus because I know how to have a puss.
Sorry.
Hate that.
I'm gonna get a heart. No, that's good. One more. Let's do one more. You give me a suggestion of anything at all.
Toast.
Great job. Toast. That's your suggestion. Last one. Go.
Sex with me is like toast. Those little knobs on the thing. You have no idea what they mean. Sex with me is like toast. If you don't do it soon, it's gonna go stale.
Sex with me is like toast. If you fuck it up, the entire house is gonna know.
I think we learned a lot about our players just then. So great. I need Kyle, Janelle, and Jack to stay up here. Everyone else can go have a seat. Grab some chairs for yourselves. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Philip. I'm just going to get down here for a second. All right, we're going to play a game called Advice Panel. And the way this works is we're at a conference. What kind of career conference trade show are we at? I heard beekeeping. Yeah. This is a beekeeping conference. Yes. Would you like individual suggestions?
Yeah.
Great. For Jack, can I have a suggestion of a magazine that you can think of? Vogue is your magazine. For Janelle, do you have anything in mind that you want? Or I can get you?
Anything, maybe an animal, I don't care.
An animal.
Tiger,
I heard first. And Kyle, you have anything in particular you want?
Maybe a profession?
Yeah, what's a profession?
Gardener.
Nice.
I heard gardener.
I heard gardener.
Awesome, great. So we are going to be at a beekeeping conference. These will be our experts. I will be running the panel, and we're going to see this advice panel in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well, hello and welcome. I am so glad that you could all be here today for our beekeeping panel of experts. You're going to be blown away by all these experts we have today. I'm not even going to introduce them. I'm going to let them introduce themselves. Start with you. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
That is all right.
Okay.
Hello, I'm Hans. Yeah. I'm normally running nightclub at this time, but here I'm with you today to share an experience.
Thank you, Hans. Thank you so much, Hans.
Yeah.
Great, and can you please introduce yourself?
I'm Tess. I like bees, and I like all of you.
Thank you, Tess.
Yes, hello. I have two names. My first name that most people call me is just Sunbeam. But the name that I really wish I had is actually just the color orange. And I don't mean the color orange. I mean the literal color orange.
Do you want me to call you orange, or do you want me to call you the color orange?
I want you to look inside of you and decide.
Okay, Sunbeam. Okay. Great. So my first question for all of you is, I know how my childhood really led to a bonding with bees and led to my career in beekeeping. What is it that drew you to the wonderful art of beekeeping?
Yeah, there has been quite a buzz in the club lately. I would like you to come by any evening between 2 a.m. to 5 a.m, and things will be very exciting at the club. Everyone is buzzing. That is why I am interested in bees.
That's wonderful, Hans. I love it.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
Okay, yes, Tess.
I like bees. I like to slink on my prey and look at the little bee and pounce and take them in my little sharp pointers.
Claws? Are you talking about claws?
And see how delicate they are and squash them.
No! This is a beekeeping conference, Tess.
And in order to observe them, they have to be squashed. Yes.
Wow. Okay. And Sunbeam,
yes.
What brought you to beekeeping?
Well, it's really quite simple. For a majority of my adult life, I have also lived in a colony. And I quite enjoy being one of the hive. I also enjoy celebrating our queen. Oh, do I enjoy celebrating her.
Well, that's a reason I can get behind. Does anyone have any questions about beekeeping that you want to learn or hear from our experts?
Why the smoke?
Yes, that's a great question. Why the smoke when you're beekeeping? Why do you, how and why do you smoke?
So in the club, we do not have smoking anymore because the smoke causes chaos, and the same is true for the bees. When the bees see the smoke, it's chaos. Yeah?
Sure. Yeah. Whatever.
Thank you.
Yeah. Tess.
I like the smoke method. I like the smoke getting all around. Getting the bees riled up makes the hunt a little more risque, a little more challenging. I like the smoke.
This is a beekeeping.
Yeah.
Tess. Okay, Sunbeam.
Well, the answer is quite simple, really. In our colony, we actually do a large number of illicit drugs. And one of the drugs is literally the smoke we use in beehives. We huff that stuff until the sun comes up. I don't know what's in it, but it does make me feel quite nice.
Hans, that's something you might also understand.
I think you was at the club a couple weeks ago. There was a guy dancing on the counter, and he was tripping hard, and he looked like you.
Yes, I don't often leave the confines of our colony, but if I smoke enough, Lord knows where I end up.
All right, any more questions?
What do you do about honey?
Okay, what do you do about the honey? Ooh. Do you mean with the honey?
Yeah, what do you do with the honey?
What do you do with the honey, each of you?
Yes, so at the bar, people will be laying on the bar covering themselves with honey. And then, not everyone, about half will cover with honey, the other half will be licking off the honey. Is that the, yes.
Yes.
That sounds amazing.
Yes. It's quite sensual.
Okay. Tess.
I would like to lick that honey. I like honey. I like licking it off of things. So I use the honey to lick it.
Ah. You lick it.
So yes. We are simpatico.
Yes.
Simpatico.
Sunbeam.
Yes. Well, you see, we have two uses for honey in our colony. The first is all of our machines run off of it. The second is we've done away with clothing and now we only wear honey. Honey is our clothing. It's also our currency.
Wow. Wow. And you had one more question?
Oh, I was asking about invasive Africanized bees.
Oh, that's a great question. What did you want to know about them?
How do you prevent them from invading your hive?
We have heard so much about invasive African bees in hives, invading them, invading, like going inside them.
Yeah.
Can you tell us more, Hans, about how you
I don't
how things
know
get
about
inside
that,
things?
But maybe after this we just find we get a quick drink and we hang out and maybe I'll show you the honey.
Okay.
Does that answer your question?
That's great. This panel is over. Learned a lot about beekeeping. Janelle, you don't keep bees by killing them. All right, was that advice panel a one, a two, a three, a four, a five?
It's a four, really, a four, four, and a four.
Let's bring up give them all a round of applause. Before that, I just want to tell you a couple things that during intermission that you can do. Remember all these QR codes we mentioned earlier? Well, one of them is a way that you can sign up for a free intro to improv class. Do you watch this and do you think, I could do better than that? Fucking try it! Sorry, I spit on this entire area. But for real, improv is something that we really believe in that is really wonderful, not only for eventually getting on the stage as these performers came through our classes, but also it's great for life skills like communication, thinking quickly on your feet, and also for making friends. It's hard to make friends as an adult, isn't it? What's your name?
Emily,
we're friends now. And that's what improv does. So sign up. We have a bunch of these coming up right now because a new session is starting soon. So do that. You can do that here or you can go up there and sign up. Also our food menu. Also join our mailing list because we give away a lot of free tickets. How many of you, by round of applause, got free tickets tonight? Yeah, so all of our lovely mailing lists.
There's an 8-drink minimum.
That's right. There isn't. There isn't. Heather's our new managing director, everybody. It's true. Great. So please sign up for that. And also, while I'm mentioning that, you'll find out about all kinds of special events first, including we have a Chroma Comedy Festival coming up starting in May 15th through the 19th. It's all BIPOC improvisers from across the country, including three-peat. If you ever saw a YouTube video called The Blackening, it's a horror film, I'm sure you've seen it, where they're being chased and then they have to decide which person goes out first because the black person always dies first, but they're all black. And so it's a really, I'm sure you've seen it. Three-peat, they're gonna be here. They have shows on Comedy Central. They write for late night. So check out the Chroma Comedy Festival. Sign up for the email list. You'll find out more. All right, now we're going to go into our final game of the first half. It's called Inner Songalog. These three performers are going to be doing a scene. Any point, I can ring my bell. I will tell them to start doing an inner songalog. They're going to step forward. They're going to sing a song that reveals their character's inner thoughts and feelings. The other characters will not hear this. They're just sharing that inner world with you. And then when they're done with the song, they'll go back to the scene.
And that's the way this game is played. Alex, what would you like for a suggestion for your inner songalog?
I would love a platonic relationship between three people, so a non-romantic relationship.
Timbers.
What was right here? Coworkers, thank you. And where do we work?
Arby's,
thank you so much. We work at Arby's. Yes, totally. Was this also Wendy's here?
Yes,
Wendy's
at Arby's. Right, yeah.
Are you Arby's. Hungry? Yeah.
Not even
to say, we do have the food menu right here. All right, we're going to see this inner song along. Countdown with me in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Patricia, I'm tired of working the night shift. Okay, I want breakfast. I want breakfast at Arby's. I can't handle the 12 a.m. shift anymore.
Lucia.
I'm tired.
I understand. The call of the evening meat is not for all. To start a breakfast at Arby's would be like a revolution in this franchise. And I'm not saying I'm against it. I say we break in 7 a.m. in the morning. We go there and we heat up that meat. We heat that meat no matter what.
Patricia, you're getting my meat real hot right now. With all this breakfast talk.
Hi. Oh. It's good to see y'all.
Yes. Hey, Marge.
Excellent to see you as well, yeah. Marge.
Roz, inner song-along.
I'm allergic to eggs, but it's been a while since I've had sex. And when you love someone, you stand with all they want. When you love someone, you say, you say yes. So I'll stand there in anaphylactic shock. And as my mouth begins to swell, I'll look at the girl who makes my heart go knock knock, and I'll say, this ain't like hell. I'll swell for you.
Because obviously I love working here. And I just wanted to give you guys the new employee handbooks. I totally studied, so if you want to copy my notes or, you know, have any questions, just let me know.
Heather, inner song-along.
Everyone thinks that I'm a good at two shoes, but I'm gonna tell you the truth. Steal from the cash box every night. That's not all that I do. One time I stole her uniform shirt just for her to get in trouble. And this one I ran it out because he didn't clock out for lunch on his double. I'm not good, I'm bad.
About, you know, employee relationships.
Thank you for the reminder, Marge.
Yeah, of course.
Marge, you are such a buzzkill. You come in here at 12 a.m., which is the party hour in Arby's, with new handbooks, just to make us feel like trash.
Alex, inner song-along.
Well, just last week, I got bit by a bat, which is why I want to work in the morning, because this is my normal time to feast. That's right, I am now a vampire, here I am, and I need a new person to suck their blood, and I'm hoping
score the last game of the first half? Was that a one, a two, a three, a four, a five? We're going to give Philip a moment to add up those scores. I'm just going to let you know that after this at 9:30, we have an All-Stars show. We will have many of the people you see here tonight, and we will do a format called Time Bomb where we'll have to run through a bunch of scenes that the tech will control how long they are. They're going to be from 10 to 30 to a minute. 10 seconds, 30 seconds, 2 minutes, 2 minutes to 4 minutes, and we won't know how long each scene is going to be. And that's super fun. Starts at 9:30, so call your babysitters, call your friends, tell them you're going to be about an hour late. It's all just going to be an hour. Starts at 9:30, done by 10. You're going to get home, you're going to get in bed, you're going to fall asleep by 11, so you can go for your hike in the morning. All right. Philip, do you have the scores? Oh, and one thing. That All-Star show would normally cost $40,000, $50,000, $60,000.
We are a nonprofit. Yeah.
But for you tonight, because you're awesome, it's free! So do stick around and enjoy that with us. All right, let's make a drum roll. Going in intermission, our lead player is Heather!
Yes, yes. Baby, calm down. She said, won't you calm down? I'm not all right, but it's all on you. Let's watch the sun down. Waves in the background, we can dance by the moonlight, but that's all you.
Shut up, boy, you're acting crazy. I don't love you anymore. Your things get a little bit hazy. We'll just blame it on the dance floor. So what if we're drunk and stupid? So what if we're way too high? So what if we just do it all night, all night?
Make sure you know that's all on you. It's all on you. Damn right. If it's gonna be all night, just don't forget it's all on you. It's all on you,
babe. Baby, come by. So won't you come by? You're like, okay, but that's all on you. I think you're in love. You can't just get enough. I know you're playing hard to get, but that's on you.
Shut up, girl, you're acting crazy. I don't love you anymore. If things get a little bit hazy, we'll just blame it on the dance floor. So what if we're drunk and stupid? So what if we're way too high? So what if we just do it
all night, all night?
Alright, if it's gonna be all night, just make sure you know it's all on you. It's all on you. Damn right. If it's gonna be all night, just don't forget it's all on you. If we can't take this,
now I'm afraid it's gonna break us.
Should we take a step back and change it? Ooh,
ooh. I don't know, no. This could be something, and we're running out of time.
There's only one way to find out. Alright, if it's gonna be alright, just make sure you know it's all on you. It's all on you. Damn right. If it's gonna be alright, just don't.
For Hazel over there at the door.
With Andrea and Maddie are both back there. Andrea and Maddie back at the bar, handling things.
And we have some awesome volunteers. I can't see them, but like give a round of applause for all of our volunteers.
And Lucky as well.
Oh, and Lucky as well. Lucky at the door as well. Yes, Hazel and Lucky. I couldn't see Lucky anymore. Awesome. So we're going to do something a little bit different here in our second half. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna invite our top three players from the first half to step forward. Heather, Roz, and Kyle, let's give them a round of applause. Now these three performers are now the only ones in contention for being tonight's winners of Showdown. That's right, they have eliminated everybody else. And what each person will now be is a director of their own film. They will get suggestions from you, and then they will tell you the title and the genre of each of their movies. And then one at a time, they'll direct the first act of each of their movies. Then you will vote on which two continue on. And then we'll see the second act of each of those two movies, and then you will vote on which one goes on to its glorious conclusion, and that player will be the winner of tonight's showdown. That's how it works. Let's start with Roz.
Excellent. Hi, audience. I want you to think about a place that you go to, don't say it yet, in your everyday life that might have a few different areas to it, a few different elements to it, just a mundane location for you. I heard a gym. Is that true? Yes. I'm going to take gym.
Great. Thank you, Roz.
And I need a suggestion. What's like a fun job you had as a kid that isn't a fast food restaurant?
Sorry, one more time.
Grocery store? I'll take grocery store.
Okay, a lot of grocery stores. Grocery. Trader Joe's?
Yeah. We're all dating from fast food to groceries. Yeah. Yeah, what is like a fancy last name? Like you think of a fancy family. I just heard salamander first.
I like it.
Pretty fancy.
It is a very fancy last name.
Pretty fancy. What is like a silly crime that's not really a crime? Something
jaywalking.
A lot of jaywalking. Okay, I guess I'll take that. And lastly,
jaywalking is a crime.
It is a crime, you're right. Sarcasm, jaywalking. Okay, all right, it was a dumb question. What is your favorite state that's not Oregon? Wisconsin, thank you so much. There we go.
All right, great. And we will now hear the title and genre of each director's film.
I present to you a travel food documentary, but not just any. Think edgy, Anthony Bourdain, may he rest in peace, kind of style. And the title of this food travel documentary is Reps Unspotted.
I'm gonna do a teenage coming of age movie called At the Co-op.
I'm gonna do like a haunted house horror type film, and it's called Scaling Down. It's a thinker. It's a thinker.
Is it? Is nope. it a thinker? Nope. All right. And all the directors can play in each other's films, and I will also be playing hey, in these films. So without any further ado, Roz, take us away.
We open on some B-roll of people in the treadmill area of the gym. Puffing and puffing or strolling along. Now, as this B-roll is playing, our host is doing a voiceover on downstage left. And our host gives some kind of cynical, but also gently loving commentary on what it means to be at the gym.
It's really nothing better than taking care of yourself. I think it's important to do that from a mental standpoint and a physical standpoint. It's silly, we have these machines inside of these walls that replicate the outside. The floor just keeps moving and moving, and yet we stay in the same place the whole time.
Treadmill section of the gym with their guide. And our host is going to introduce himself and his guide as well.
Hello, my name is Clanthony Schmorbane.
Incredible, no notes.
What's that?
That's
no
perfect.
Notes? Okay, great, good. And I'm here at the Gold Gym with our very smart, fit, and just so skilled guide today. This is personal trainer John John.
Hey y'all. Hey y'all. Hey. Hey y'all. What's going on? Just kidding. Just kidding. We're at the gym, everybody.
All right. We cut to our very first meal, which is breakfast. We're here over at the treadmill section of the gym, and
a lot of people like to.
Breakfast setup. And our guide tells us about the exotic gym meal that Clanthony is having for breakfast.
So the people are just running while we eat, huh?
Oh, yeah. A lot of people. It's about community, man. Yeah. Right? Have you ever been part of the community? You're part of the community now.
That's great. That sounds awesome.
Look Let's around.
Let's go!
See?
Let's go!
Now these you're gonna love. One of the guys swings by Wendy's on the way every morning before the gym, grabs the burgers from the last day half price. See again.
Old Wendy's burgers for breakfast.
Well, new to you.
That's true, that's true.
Just then we hear a voiceover of Clanthony describing the taste of this burger and what it means for the gym goers.
There was nothing new about the flavor of this burger. It tasted precisely like a day-old burger that was picked up from Wendy's. But because I had never experienced this before, and the man right behind me was sweating right onto my back, I decided not to complain. After all, when you jump, you gotta trust. The universe wants to catch you. So that's exactly what I did.
You got...
Go ahead, sorry.
Well, I just wanted to say you gotta make sure to, you know, get some vitamins and minerals before you work out, and nothing better than some day old Wendy's.
John, would it be all right if I smoked a cigarette in this gym?
That would not be good.
Oh, all right.
I don't want smoke filling up the gym like some beehive or something, okay?
I had to ask you, part of the diet here in this gym, do you care about how healthy the food is, or do you just not give a shit?
I think fuel is fuel. You know, there was a famous poet that said, give me fuel, give me fire, give me, I forget the rest. But that poet didn't forget the rest. He wrote that whole poem. He probably had a big breakfast.
You are.
If you're not gonna finish that, I'll eat it.
Oh yeah, please.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, by thank all means. You.
How many miles did you run?
0.75.
Oh. Hey, it doesn't matter. Food is fuel.
Food is fuel.
Food is fuel.
And now we cut to some B-roll footage of the weightlifting section.
Yep. Yep.
Anthony is going to give us some foreboding voiceover about the more threatening part of the gym that he's about to enter.
The strange moving floors were fine for me. I felt like it was just silly, sort of like a clown act. But the other room terrified me. A bunch of people looking at themselves in mirrors, lifting random objects. See, I didn't realize this, but it was a CrossFit gym. So they were lifting desks and tractor tires, mattresses, and half of a car. I didn't understand it. That's exactly why I walked right in.
And blackout!
We open on a small neighborhood co-op grocery store. We see four teenagers, forgot how many people are here, four teenagers working in this co-op, and they all introduce themselves and their teen stereotype.
Hi, I'm Agnes, and I'm an aspiring botanist. Nothing fills me with more passion than the array of horticulture before me.
I'm Maxine, and I used to want to be a ballet dancer until I realized the existential dread that fills this world.
Hey, I'm Jake. My parents are rich.
I'm Kelly. I'm pretty.
Great. And then our boss of the co-op walks in and has some disappointing news.
Okay, guys.
Hi, hey. Mr. Patchouli.
Hey, kids. How are we doing today?
Always good.
Just Mr. P stopping by to see how work's going.
Oh my God, Mr. P.
Hey.
I was just wondering if you would mind, you wouldn't, right? If I leave a little early today. I have to get ready for a big party at the school.
You know, that's okay. Just before you go, I gotta tell y'all something. Basically, we're closing at the end of this week.
Because
we're not a profitable business anymore. I know you came by my office last week. You saw me crying into a book. That was the bookkeeping. And we're
but
not.
Mr. P, this is the only place that I can work without working.
This is the only place that carries Danish rutabaga.
I appreciate all the special skills we all bring to the job. That's what's helped it flourish over the years. You know, you all have such great talents, you have such wealthy parents.
Yeah. I was gonna say, it honestly doesn't really affect me because I don't get paid here anyway. So.
Okay, well.
Honestly, I'm ready to see late stage capitalism do its thing, so shut it down.
Okay, well, I know not all of you, you know, I live in that back office, so this is important. This is gonna be tough. So I just wanted to let you know, by the end of the week, you know, unless somehow we get a influx of $25,000.
Wait, that's all it's gonna take?
it's a lot of money.
Doesn't seem like a lot of money to me, but if that's what, you know, we need. So
well,
we
I also have some student loans that I haven't paid off. I was holding out, but you know, Biden. So, yeah, it's a lot of money.
All right, Mr. Patchouli, I get it.
I know that's a lot to just say to you and then walk away.
Are you gonna walk away? All right, walk away. Guys, look, I know that I don't, you know, really need this job, but I need you guys. Like, aww. I don't have any other friends, so if this place closes, I'll probably just stop being your friend.
Oh, God.
Wait, please, no.
I know.
He just looked like a little puppy, you know? Mr. P just looks so sad.
It's pathetic. P must stand for pathetic.
It stands for patchouli. Also, guys, did you know he lived here? I didn't know that.
I mean, I for one think it's so admirable that a man has stuck to his passions for so long. In a world of mass corporatized jalapenos with no spice, he stands for the heirloom. This is the hill that I'm dying on!
I mean, his loans must be super bad because he dropped out of college right in his last semester of law school.
Oh, God, he dropped out?
Yeah.
Yeah, and honestly, they've forgiven like most people's loans, so I don't know why he still has that.
Because he dropped out.
Shit.
I think they're like, if you quit, we quit helping you.
That's soft.
I think that was literally what Joe Biden said.
So yeah, the teens devise a plan to save the grocery
store. Look, I know your guys' first idea is for me to go talk to my parents.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
But they're not
you
really
literally
talking.
Said it's not that much money.
Well, it's literally not, but I got to be honest with you guys. I got kicked out. I can't go back to them.
Oh.
Yeah.
Why'd you get kicked out?
Yeah.
Mostly because I just don't have any ambition.
Look, you guys, we should do like a bikini car wash or something.
Oh, gosh. I mean, I just think perhaps we should do something that showcases our minds rather than our bodies.
Honestly, let's just burn it all down and take the insurance payout.
Wow, it's not a bad idea.
Not a bad idea, actually.
I have access to the chemistry lab.
Oh, we're entertaining this?
Oh, yeah. I think we just need to make sure we do it in a way that nobody can trace it to us.
Also, we have to make sure Mr. Patchouli isn't still in the building when we do it.
That's a really good point.
That's a huge risk.
Right, if we burn it down, we're going to end up burning down all of his stuff.
That's
and that's
true.
Everything he has.
All right, I guess we won't burn the building down.
Yeah.
I really liked that idea. Yeah.
They come up with a better plan.
Some sort of, like, bake sale?
We're a grocery store.
All right, you know what? Fuck it.
Put on a talent show. With everybody who works here and Mr. Patchouli.
Oh, that would be awesome to see Mr. Patchouli's talent.
Yeah.
I can twirl a baton like it's nobody's business.
I am happy to run lights because I have stage fright.
But you could do like something with your chemistry set.
Are we going back to the fire? No, I'm sorry. I'll figure something out. I'll do something with chemistry.
Is there anything you can do other than depress everybody?
Well, I was gonna say I can read my journal and really scare the money out of them.
Ah, a poet, a wordsmith.
Whatever.
I didn't want to admit this.
Come on.
But I'm actually a virtuosic piano player, so I was forced into lessons at a young age.
Well, I think we have the makings of a variety show that could make a ton of money. Because you know what makes money? Live entertainment.
And blackout!
Oh, wait, is that all? No.
Okay.
We open in a nice minivan. A nice minivan where there's a family driving. A nice, wholesome family driving along. There's back seats and front seats in this minivan. And there's a whole family there, just of the three. And we meet our three characters, and they are moving to Wisconsin.
The day has come.
Wow.
Wisconsin!
look at these rolling. Look everywhere. I can see everything.
Wow.
We excited back there?
I heard they have cheese, and you know I'm lactose intolerant.
We brought our pills for that, you know?
Take a lactate, honey.
Ooh, give me one.
We hear a little bit about why they're moving to Wisconsin.
Why do we have to move to stupid Wisconsin anyway?
Because we need to take care of Grandma and Grandpa, honey.
They love you, and it's time for us to return all of the favors. You know, they raised us. Now we're going to watch them as they age and die. But, sorry.
Jesus,
we're 65. We got a lot of life to live.
Yeah, what Mom's trying to say, we're going to be in Wisconsin for a while, you know? It's time to get excited about this.
They start pulling into the property where the grandma and grandpa live, and things don't look quite right.
There's the spot. Oh, where's the RV? What's going on?
Someone approaches the minivan that's not grandma or grandpa.
Huh. I get, we just honk or so.
Beep, beep.
Hello. Huh.
Holy shit.
Oh my God.
Ah! Oh!
Jesus Christ!
Oh!
Hi!
Don't roll, okay, yeah.
Hey, you gonna go in the house?
Yeah, that's where—
Didn't you hear about what happened in the house?
No.
Everybody knows!
Our family lives in that.
Not anymore.
Oh!
Your family died in that house! And you know who killed him? The house!
Oh, and we black out!
All right, very quick review and preview of what's to come.
Yes, that's me. In Reps Unspotted, Clanthony, our host, is taking us through the seedy underbelly of the local gym. We've had some old Wendy's breakfast by the treadmills, and now Clanthony is going to venture into parts
real
unfamiliar.
Quick, Roz, real quick.
Okay, yeah. So what's gonna happen with the weightlifters? What's he gonna have for lunch? What else is gonna happen? Find out in the second act of Reps Unspotted.
Yeah. We just found out that the grocery co-op is in trouble, like most of them. and the teens are working together to figure out how they can save it and Mr. Patchouli. Are they gonna do it? Are they not? Is the rich kid gonna finally fucking ask his parents? Because that would be a short way to end the movie.
Find out if you vote for
At the Co-op.
Our nice, happy family just arrived in Wisconsin, and they were approached by what seemed to be Harry Carey walking out to the door. Are the grandparents alive or are they dead? You'll only find out if you vote for Scaling Down.
I will hold my hand over each director's head. You will cheer at least a little bit for all of them because we're not monsters, Emily. And you will cheer the most for the ones you want to continue. Is it our Reps Unspotted? Is it At the Co-op? Is it Scaling Down? Say goodbye to Roz. And we are going to have a speed round.
We open back outside the grocery store in the parking lot where the teens are setting up for the super awesome talent show.
Goggles on.
I never knew that you could play the piano.
Yeah, that's why I said I didn't want to tell you guys.
So, why?
Because you didn't know. That's why I didn't want to tell. Anyway. I don't know. I feel like I don't want to come off as a sensitive dude, you know? I'm tough. I know what the real world's like, you know what I mean? Like
I've been ha 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 ha. Ha. Joke I've heard all day. Are you sure your talent isn't stand up.
Oh my God, get a room, you two.
Your
the
talent?
Tension is so intense.
Really? Because I don't feel it at all.
Same.
Your talent is just to read from your sad diary? That's what your talent is?
What's your talent? Being a little rich daddy's boy who makes it rain on the audience so they feel bad for you?
Ooh,
no, it's piano.
I bet you can't even play.
Why are you so against me?
Because you're everything I've ever wanted to be.
Rich?
Hey, what are all your teens?
Oh, Mr. Patchouli's away.
What are all your teens doing out front here? What are you doing? We don't start for an hour or two.
We're getting set up for the talent show, Mr. P. We're doing an 8 a.m. talent show. Before the store opens. And we're all bringing a talent. I'm going to twirl a baton.
Yeah.
She's going to do the lights. He's going to play piano. She's going to read poetry. And the headliner is going to be you.
Oh, I got to do a talent.
Yeah, what's your talent, Mr. P? Because we know you have one.
Oh, I got a couple of things in my back pocket I guess I could pull out if needed. Yeah, I got a thing or two.
Yeah?
Like
yeah.
What?
Well, I was doing your taxes and you know.
Can't be doing taxes, Mr. P.
Okay, I gotta log into Nelnet and pay my student loan.
Oh.
Hey, Mr.
We're
P.
so fucked.
Think about your counterculture days back in the 1960s. A hub of creative expression. Surely you picked up some kind of exotic instrument or new age talent?
I guess back in the days I lived in New York City, I frequented Tin Pan Alley, where they wrote all the hits of the day. I guess I got a little songwriting talent in me.
Well, that's wonderful news, because we have a pianist.
Yeah, and that's kind of already my skill, though, so I don't think...
I didn't know you played piano. Why didn't you tell us?
Another person found out.
I'm going to text my friends about it.
No, don't. That's between us.
Oh, okay.
But truly...
You gotta tell your friends so people come.
Oh,
go get your phone. It's only like 3 feet away.
And you're okay. Gonna play.
It's right there.
No, it's farther.
And black.
we open up in the strange person that was like Harry Carey. They're just sitting in the building they live in, staring out the window at the family that's going into the house. And this character is muttering to themselves.
You really gonna go in there? I wouldn't go in there if I were you. You're gonna get murdered. You'll get murdered by the house.
And we black out.
All right, let's get our two directors out of here. Right, very quick recap and preview.
Mr. Patchouli, does he have a talent? Is he going to find his phone? Well, you're not going to know ever, and you won't be able to sleep tonight if you don't vote for At the Co-op.
Yeah, At the Co-op.
That was really fast. At first I thought it was Harry Carey, now I'm not so sure. Where the hell is the salamander at? I don't know. But we'll find out if you vote for Scaling Down.
Scaling Down. All right, here you go. You're a vote for both. Remember, we made that agreement, Emily. Okay, here we go. Is it At the Co-op?
That's right. This is a plot we all connect with. We open up on the family walking into the house. Ominous music is sort of playing. It's a little uncomfortable.
Keep in front of us.
Okay, I guess I'll be the... Okay, everything's fine, y'all. We don't need to listen to that. Did you look at that person's...
Oh, it's got green.
It's okay. Grandma and Grandpa just like to keep it dark in the house. This is normal, okay? See, here's the kitchen. What a nice kitchen.
Mom! Oh. Grammy! Grampy!
They start hearing reptile sounds.
Wow.
That's right. Reptile sounds.
What was that sound? I don't recognize it.
Hey, Google, turn music off.
Alexa, turn music off. Try Siri?
Yeah, it worked. All right.
Siri.
It works. It worked.
Sorry, I just love technology. Yeah. Okay.
One of them worked.
Yeah. Suddenly, a little salamander scurries across them on the floor.
Okay.
What was that?
What?
It's on the wall.
Oh, fuck.
Don't kill it, Dad.
That's just one of Grandpa's pets, old pets.
Honey, you're strong. Hey. Damien,
remember
warrior.
Me?
Go get it.
Remember me, Damien? I used to take you out of your little play pit and...
Oh, fuck. Oh my God, is Dad gonna die?
They realize they have to get out of the house, but the doors are locked.
We gotta go. Okay. Oh my God. Turn the knob. Oh, it's actually locked.
What about the door that we came in through?
Oh my God.
Another salamander scurries across and joins on this wall.
Oh. I told you it was stupid to move to stupid Wisconsin.
I think that we...
It's looking at us weird. Boom!
Oh no, not this guy!
What are those? Are those nunchucks?
That's right. Harry Carey is here with nunchucks.
It wasn't the house! It was a salamander!
And we black out!
Oh my God!
Either way, we want to see you here more. Please come back. You've been amazing. I just have two questions. Did you have fun?
Yes.
Did you?